Okay, now we can start, ma'am.
Good afternoon to all dear participants and our respected speaker, Professor Darshan Mehta, sir. Welcome, sir. And I hope everyone enjoyed their lunch. And we can understand after lunch, this is very difficult to listen any lecture. But we are having that much enthusiastic speaker between us, having a very vast experience in the field of water resource engineering, right? So I will request Dr. Yazid Zabbar, sir, to please give introduction of our eminent speaker to all the participants so we can start our second session. Yazid, sir.
Yazid, sir, to you.
Good afternoon to all who are present, and to Professor Darshan Mehta, who is our speaker at present. Professor Darshan Mehta is an assistant professor in Department of Civil Engineering in Dr. S&SS Gandhi Government Engineering College, Surat. He had done his bachelor's in GC Surat in 2011. His master's specialization was in water resources management, and he is currently pursuing his PhD from SVNIT Surat. He has an overall teaching experience of about 8.5 years, and he has worked in various positions as an assistant professor in Sasit College, and he has also worked in GC Surat since 2017. He has secured his first rank in GPSC as assistant and secured a position as assistant professor in the GPSC interview. He has received National Eminent Academic Leader Award in 2020 from International Institute of Organized Research, I2OR, which is said as ITOR India. He has published more than 85 research papers in reputed national and international journals, as well as conferences. He has reviewed more than 100 papers in national and international journals and conferences, and he has been in the reviewer process in many international journals. He is having a professional membership in ISTE, IEI, IAHR, ISH, and ASC, that is American Society of Civil Engineers. He has attended more than 30 conferences and 30 workshops and STTP and seminars. He has organized Gujcost-sponsored two-day national conference. He has also taken up Atal AICT FDP for 1 week, and he has sponsored that. He has worked on it, and 1 week STTP on self-finance, which is a self-finance STTP. He has received consecutive 8 times seminar symposium conference grants from Gujcost, and have published and book titled 1D Hydrodynamic Flood Modeling to Identify Flood Prone Areas. He has also published a book titled Civil Engineering Interview Questions, and he has delivered more than like dozens of expert lectures on various topics related to river hydraulics and civil engineering. He has received 2 times Best Paper Award in various conferences, and he have guided more than 23 students at UG level and more than 13 students at PG level. He is a joint secretary at Institute of Engineers, SDLC, Surat, from 2018 to 2021. And during this lockdown period, Darshan, sir, can you?
Hello. Am I audible to everyone? Okay,
yes, sir.
Fine.
You are audible.
So I'm just sharing my screen. Okay, I hope my screen is visible to everyone. Just confirm here.
Yes, sir, visible, perfect.
Okay, fine. So, good afternoon, everyone, all the participants, principal, sir, head of the department, coordinator of this particular today's workshop, co-coordinator of this today's workshop, and the faculty members of Civil Engineering Department of SNPIT Umrak. And first of all, I would like to thank the organizers and the head of the department and principal for giving me the opportunity to share some knowledge regarding the research trends in the field of water resource engineering and basically on the virtual platform. I know it is very much tough to bear me after the lunch session, but I can say that you will not get bored in this particular session, because I will make this session somewhat interactive and you also have to be active if I am asking some question during the session. So before starting with that, I would like to thank Dr. S.I. Vaikom, Dr. S.M. Yadav sir, who is the guide when I was doing PG. I would also like to thank Gujarat Council on Science and Technology, GUJCOST, Government of Gujarat, who has given me the opportunity to deliver a talk on this virtual platform, which is organized by the Umrak College, SNPIT Umrak. I also would like to thank Dr. Piyush Jain, the principal of this institute. And lastly, the main base, Dr. Damayanti, Dr. Yazid Jabbar, Professor Keyur Shah, and Professor Nikunj Ashiani, those who are working since last few days for making this event a grand success. So this is the first day of your particular workshop. So once again, I would like to thank and congratulations for this 2 days workshop and considering the research trends topic on the various area. So basically, I told you that today I am going to talk on a recent trend in the field of water resource engineering. And if we talk for a 1 hour or a 2 hour or a 3 hour, I think it is very much less to share what are the various trends in the market and what are the various trends in the specific field of WRE, water resource engineering, for doing the research. As you people are aware that there are lots of things which are advanced, which are came into the market, and day by day there are certain change, lots of changes in the field of this civil engineering as well as the water resource engineering field. So basically, if we talk about on the virtual platform, right? So since last April 2020, we can say March mid 2020 until date, we all are on the virtual platform, or you can say on the online platform. We students will going to attend the lectures, faculty are delivering the lecture via online mode, whatever the expert lecture, webinars or training or everything, we all are acquainted and we are familiar with the online platform. So today, why I am focusing on this online platform? Because today, if I give you some work or if I give you some topic to carry out on a particular research field, so you won't be able to visit your study area, you won't be able to visit the area which you want to work or from where you have to collect the data for that particular specific region, right? So by focusing on that, we are planning that if we go for a virtual era, then we have many emerging areas which are developed or which are given by AICT, that is the soft computing, then artificial intelligence, then robotics, then cyber security. These are the various emerging area, machine learning, intelligence. These all are the various emerging area which we can apply on any of the field. I'm not talking about the civil engineering, I'm not talking about the mechanical, I'm not talking about the water resource. We can apply in every engineering branch, right? But today, as my topic is water resource engineering, so I'm not going into depth for the other engineering branch. I'm just focusing on the water resource engineering branch. So these are the contents which I'm going to show you in my next slide, But what are the various emerging areas in the field of water resource engineering? Now, see, from my first point, the impact of salt application to the streams. First of all, we must have to understand that water resource engineering is a very broad scope. In fact, we can say the civil engineering is a very broad scope in which we have various, or you can say numerous number of sub-branches. In this, water resource engineering is one of the branch in which one will be able to do, or one will be able to carry out so many things related to the higher study, related to the consultancy, related to the field job, many things, right? So these are the various emerging area. If anybody is interested to go on it, so you can particularly focus on such areas. So first is the impact of salt application to the streams. See, I am not going with the all the sentences, all the lines. You just have to focus on the line which I have highlighted. So first point says that we need to go for a seawater intrusion. We need to go for a salinity. We need to go for an impact. What is the impact of that? Now see, I am taking one example that which I am going to share in my next slides. Say, if I am releasing the water from the dam, that, right? So what will be the impact on the Surat city? What will be the impact on the areas which are adjoining or which are nearer to the Surat city if I release the water? So that impact is also most important. So many researchers have carried out many kinds of work, and right now you all people are aware that if anybody is going to go for a PhD, if anybody is going for an MTech thesis or dissertation, we have one parameter, that is a research gap. What is the research gap? How to find out the research gap, right? So for research gap, we need to focus on the emerging areas. But which are the emerging areas and what are the scopes of that? Right, because we are aware that if I can work on seawater intrusion, if I can work on the salinity, if I can work on the impact of climate change, if I can work for the flood forecasting, we can do the work. But the thing is, what is the process? We need to collect the data, we need to visit the site, and just we can collect the data and we just entering into the software and we will get the output. But that is not a research. That is only the mechanical process. That is only the mechanical process. But we can say, we can add the research parameters in this, because you already have carried out the work, you have analyzed the data, you have assessed the data, you have forecast the data. But the thing is that, what is the research component? So for research component, we need to go into depth, we need to visit the study area, we need to collect some physical data, we need to do the calibration, we need to go for validation. Then afterwards, we can develop the model. That is my pure research work, right? Now, second thing is the machine learning applications in the water resource and the Python programming. See, this is a very, very, very broad scope of emerging area. If you can see on the AICT portal, and just if you can write in the Google that emerging areas which is adopted by the AICT, so you will get so many, I think, 12 areas which are listed by AICT, and that area is machine learning, that area is artificial intelligence, that area is robotics, that area is sustainable habitat. See, I am giving you an example of sustainable habitat also in my next slide. And these are the various approaches, these are the various emerging area which one can be able to do the work. And nowadays, we can say that artificial intelligence, soft computing techniques, machine learning, Python programming are very much familiar. In market, this only works. And right now, we all are on the virtual platform. So this will purely work. Right? Only the thing is, we used to prepare a command to run my program. And if you are familiar with the C programming, if you are aware about the C programming, then you will be able to carry it out the, or you will be able to use the Python programming or any other, right? Now, next is the probabilistic approach to determining the dam breach parameters. See, dam breach parameters means dam break analysis. Another word is dam break analysis. There are number of softwares in the area of water resource field for various purposes. If you go for a dam break analysis, you have a Mike flood, you have a HackRus, you have a Hack HMS, right? You have a GeoHackRus, right? These are the various softwares which we can say can be used for a dam break analysis. Similarly, if I can go for a salinity, I told you now before starting of my lecture, first point, salinity, seawater intrusion, that is the part of groundwater. Okay, so groundwater also you can carry it out with the help of the mode flow software. Then there are certain norms also that we need to follow, right? So probabilistic approach, what is the use of probabilistic approach? Probabilistic, there are two type of approach, probabilistic and stochastic, right? Probabilistic, as the name suggested, that we need to go for some probability. We need to go for a sensitivity analysis, like prediction, whether flood may occur or not, whether the dam break failure will occur or not. So this is the probability. Either it may happen or it may not happen, right? Now, next is the effectiveness of proprietary storm water BMP, best management practices. This is purely for a consultant. Those who are interested for open their consultant in the field of water, this is purely for that. Means, see, in the Surat city, as per my knowledge, there is one consultant, that is a Faisal Mavel. The director of that company is Mr. Dr. Harshul Parekh. He is doing work for environment, he is doing work for a planning, he is doing work for a transportation as well, right? So such type of proprietary who can work for a stormwater drainage design, who can work for a water distribution network design, right? Whatever the case study which today I am going to discuss, if you will able to learn that, definitely I can say that if you open your consultant, you will earn minimum 2 to 3 lakh rupees. If you go for a design for a water distribution network, for small network, for a small ESR, you will be able to get a minimum of 2 to 3 lakh rupees consultants work, right? Next is the determine the probable maximum flood for a particular area. See, this I am going to discuss in my next case study. Then impact of maintenance on the BMP performance. This is also one of the part of management, that is the best management practice, BMP, that is a stormwater drainage design. Then compare the 1D, 2D model software packages, that is a hydraulic and hydrological modeling. Use of remote sensing, yes. This is also one of the well-known emerging area in the field of water resource engineering. That is the remote sensing techniques. See, if any of the students, those who are in the fifth semester, they might be aware that we have one subject that is the remote sensing and GIS, right? So in that you will be able to get the idea that how to prepare digital elevation model, how the tiles can be downloaded. So these are the emerging areas. See, I can take one topic for one project. I can from this, right? Then stochastic hydrology. Now, impact of land use changes on the catchment hydrology. Then sensitivity to catchment climate change. Economic benefit of stream restoration. Then rainwater harvesting. Impact of a dam on a sediment transport. And lastly, artificial intelligence, soft computing techniques, and sustainable habitat. Now, sustainable habitat says that if you consider or if you select one region which can be taken as a flood prone area and drought prone area, that can be categorized as a sustainable habitat. Now, why I have considered this topic? If anybody is interested for the research project in the field of water resource engineering, then Bhuj Coast is giving 50 lakh rupees of research grant for carrying out the research project in some areas, namely artificial intelligence, soft computing techniques, sustainable habitat, machine learning, robotics, cyber security. These are the emerging area in which Bhuj Coast is giving you the research project grant up to the limit of 50 lakh rupees. Sustainable habitat, you can consider the area which is drought prone area, which is a flood prone area, and by combining both of them, you will get the outcome as a sustainable habitat. Because none of the area can take the topic of drought, because the drought is the one topic which is a very confliction topic. No one have any action plan. We have the action plan for minimizing the flood, we have the action plan for reducing the flood of in and around the region, but we don't have the action plan for the drought management, right? And in Gujarati, we can say we have the some of the states or some of the areas where there is a drought management problem. આપણે કહીએ ને ગુજરાતમાં દુકાળ, લાઈક ધેટ, રાઈટ? નાઉ વોટ આર ધ કી ઇશ્યુઝ ટુડે? નાઉ વી આર ટોકિંગ અબાઉટ ધ રિસર્ચ ફિલ્ડ, સો વોટ આર ધ કી ઇશ્યુઝ, વોટ પીપલ ફેસિસ ધ પ્રોબ્લેમ? સી, આઈ ટોલ્ડ યુ ક્લાઇમેટ ચેન્જ. નાઉ ક્લાઇમેટ ચેન્જ, વાય આઈ કન્સિડર ક્લાઇમેટ ચેન્જ? નાઉ ઇફ યુ પીપલ આર એટ બારડોલી, નાઉ ઇન બારડોલી વી કેન સે ધ બસ સ્ટેન્ડ and your institute, I think it will be something 10 minutes, I think there is a distance of 10 minutes that you will reach from bus station to college, or you can say take 20 minutes, right? Now why I am considering this example, I just want to know, or I just want to tell you that if you are standing on this station, bus station, right? There is a heavy rainfall. Now you are traveling from rickshaw, right? When you reach to the institution at your college, there is no rainfall. This is one of the issues, that is the climate change. આપણે કહેવાય ને કે સવારે બહુ ઠંડા જેવું વાતાવરણ હોય, બપોરે બહુ તડકો લાગતો હોય, અને સાંજે પાછા જઈએ તો પાછું ઠંડુ વાતાવરણ સ્ટાર્ટ થઈ જાય. સો ધીસ ઇઝ ધી ઇફેક્ટ ઓફ ક્લાઇમેટ ચેન્જ. If I take this, those who are from the Surat city, I can give you the example of Surat city also. I am living in the Adajan area, and right now I am at Athwa gate. When I start my travel from my institute to go back to my home, at that time there is a heavy rainfall in this area, but when I reach to my place, there is no rainfall. Weather change, climate change, you can see, you can observe also daily કે આપણું પેલું વાદળા કેટલા કાળા થતા જાય, આપણને એવું લાગે હમણાં ધોધમાર વરસાદ પડશે, બટ ધેર ઇઝ નો રેનફોલ, ધેર ઇઝ નો રેનફોલ. અનધર એક્ઝામ્પલ, બિફોર ફ્યુ મંથ્સ બેક ધેર ઇઝ વન સાયક્લોન ટુક્સ પ્લેસ ઇન અવર ગુજરાત, રાઈટ? આપણે એ લોકોને બોલાવવા ગયેલા, આપણે એને કીધેલું કે ભાઈ તું આવજે. નો, ધીસ ઇઝ અ ક્લાઇમેટ ચેન્જ. વી આર નોટ able to know, we are not able to see what will happen, right? And you can see the effect ke jeu apna area mathi, jeu apna city mathi pass thai, means when it will pass from our city, you can see the change in the climate sudden, all of sudden. And tame joyu ke ase, tame badha feel bhi karyo ase that when this cyclone just passed or the just nearer to our state or our city, you just see the change in the climate, and definitely you feel ke mausam automatic change thi. Next is the increasing the vulnerability to severe weather event. Whatever just I discussed before few minutes back, the same thing, that how the vulnerability increases due to the cyclone, due to the tsunami. This all can increase the vulnerability. Growing the urban demand, this is also one of the key issue, growing the urban demand. Overall allocation of existing supply. Now take the example of water distribution network. Say I am taking one water distribution existing network for analysis point of view, right? Now in that, if the people are migrated from Varacha to Adajan, right, I am focusing on the water demand, I am focusing on the water distribution, not on the capacity, right? To ave jitla vyakti tya thi migrate thaine ahi aavya, means they shifted from Varacha to Adajan, right? People are increasing, but the demand is also increasing, but my water capacity, water ESR, elevated storage reservoir, any capacity me kya vadhavi, right? If I increase the if I can say, if the peoples are migrating from one place to another, if the population is increasing, then I need to go for the revision of ESR, or you can say the additional ESR. ESR is elevated storage reservoir in which we can store the water, and accordingly we can supply in the various societies, residential area or industrial area, right? So this is the overall allocation. Means we need to focus on all the parameters: population, people, people's demand, industry, right? Because as we all know that 135 liter per capita per day, one person can use the water. And in case of the industry, 270 liter per capita per day, industry can use. Peoples are migrating, but my demand is not going to change. Right? 1 minute. Okay, so people are migrating from one place to another, right? But we are not going to revise our ESR. We are not going to revise our capacity, right? તમે જોયો છે બધા પાણી ટાંકી ઉપર લખ્યું હોય 1 લાખ ક્યુસેક પાણી, એટલે એટલું એની કેપેસિટી 1 લાખ LPCD or 10,000 LPCD, 50,000 LPCD. So that is the storage in that particular ESR, elevated storage reservoir. Next point is the flood forecasting and the flood management. This is a very broad topic. As Dr. Yazar already told you that one of the book which I am published, that is of 1D hydrodynamic model, purely it is on flood. My dissertation is also on the flood. Flood forecasting, how to manage the flood, how to forecast the flood. The case study which I am going to discuss with you is on the same thing, that is the flood forecasting and the flood management, how to manage the flood. And I can say that if you are sitting at the home and if any higher authority is telling you that if I am releasing the water from the dam, can you tell me whether your area is under flooding or not? You will be able to tell them yes, whether I am under the flooding region or not. With the help of software. પહેલાના જમાનામાં મેન્યુઅલી આપણે બધું કરવું પડતું હતું, but nowadays due to this digital era we will be able to give any kind of things, any kind of results, any kind of output by sitting at the home. હવે હમણાં સમજો કે તમારા ત્યાંથી મને કોઈ બી એમ કહેશે કે સાહેબ હવે ઉકાઈ ડેમમાંથી આપણે પાણી છોડવામાં આવે છે 1 લાખ ક્યુસેક વોટર, કેન યુ ટેલ મી કે તમે જે જગ્યા અત્યારે સ્થાયી છો ત્યાં પાણી આવી શકે છે કે નહીં? રાઈટ, આઈ કેન જસ્ટ હેવ ટુ એન્ટર ધ ડિસ્ચાર્જ ડેટા. આઈ વિલ રાઈટલી આફ્ટર 5 મિનિટ્સ આઈ વિલ ટેલ ભાઈ નહીં, આઈ એમ વેરી સેફ. રાઈટ, ધેન નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ ધ લેન્ડ યુઝ, લેન્ડ કવર ઇફેક્ટ. સી હિયર, ધીસ ઇઝ અ વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ટોપિક. ધીસ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો વન ઓફ ધ કી ઇશ્યુઝ. Those who are from Surat, they are aware કે સુરતના અંદર સેડિમેન્ટેશનનો પ્રોબ્લેમ છે, સિલ્ટેશનનો પ્રોબ્લેમ છે, સ્કાવરનો બી પ્રોબ્લેમ છે, રાઈટ? એન્ડ ડ્યુ ટુ ધેટ યુ કેન સી, આઈ ગીવ યુ ધી એક્ઝામ્પલ, કતારગામ એરિયા, દેર ઇઝ વન જીલાની બ્રિજ. ફ્રોમ જીલાની બ્રિજ ટુ સરદાર બ્રિજ યુ કેન સી દેર ઇઝ અ યુ શેપ. આઈ એમ જસ્ટ શોઈંગ યુ. Yes, like this, if you can see on your my screen, this type of U-shape. So this U-shape is called as a river meandering. Due to this, the depth D, the velocity V, vary when the water is flowing from the dam. Now why? What will be the reason? That also I am going to show you. 1 minute. Yes. So now this is my river. See, some diagram is uneven, right? Now the direction of the flow is like this. Okay. Now, can anybody tell me that if my water is flowing in this particular direction, now focus on these lines. Okay, now my question is, the line which I have drawn, 1, 2, 3 and 4, I am releasing water 1 lakh cubic, and this is the direction, what will be the situation of velocity in 1, 2, 3, and 4? Can anybody tell what will be the situation of velocity? એટલે વેલોસિટી શું હશે? સેમ હશે, વેરી હશે? હવે વેરી છે તો ક્યાંથી ક્યાં? 1 ટુ 2 માં વેરી હશે, 2 ટુ 3 માં વેરી હશે, ઓર 3 ટુ 4 માં? યસ યસ પાર્ટિસિપન્ટ્સ, કેન યુ પ્લીઝ ટેલ મી એનીબડી? આઈ થિંક ધેર આર 34 પાર્ટિસિપન્ટ્સ ઇન્ક્લુડિંગ મી, સો યસ પ્લીઝ આન્સર. Hope my voice is audible.
Yes, audible, sir.
Yes. Okay, fine. 1 to 2. Okay, anybody else from the students? કોઈ ભી આન્સર હોય, સાચો ખોટો હું કઈ તમને ત્યાં મારવા કે કશું કહેવા નથી આવવાનું. યસ, ઇટ ઇઝ અ વર્ચ્યુઅલ પ્લેટફોર્મ, યુ વિલ ટેક ધી એડવાન્ટેજ ઓફ ધીસ પર્ટિક્યુલર પ્રેઝન્ટેશન. વોટ વિલ હેપન? એટલે આપણી વેલોસિટીને શું થશે? 1 થી 2 માં સેમ થશે, કે 2 થી 3 માં સેમ થશે, કે પછી 1 થી 2 માં વેરી થશે? કેન યુ પ્લીઝ ટેલ? દમયંતી મેડમ ઓલરેડી હેડ ગિવન ધી આન્સર ઇન ધી ચેટ બોક્સ. એની અધર પાર્ટિસિપન્ટ્સ, એની અધર સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ? ડાયગ્રામ ઇઝ ઓલરેડી ઓન યોર સ્ક્રીન. ઓકે ફાઈન, સી now the velocity will vary from 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. Why? When my water is flowing from this, at that time the velocity is okay, but when it reach to this, it will strike here. અહીંયા એ સ્ટ્રાઇક થશે, એટલે ઓટોમેટિક શું થશે? વેલોસિટી ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટ થઈ જશે અહીંયાથી, યુ કેન સી, એન્ડ ધેન ઇટ વિલ ગો ટુવર્ડ્સ ધીસ પોઈન્ટ. So the velocity at point 1 will be different than the velocity at the point 2, because it strike a aa jagya par strike thase, and then it will distribute. Take the example of pier, bridge na je pier hoy ne, to pani jare flow thatu hoy te pier par strike thane pachi j agar jay ne, right? To jare pier par strike thase tyare shu thase? Pani tamaru distribute thase, it means the velocity will get distributed. Etle tya particular position upar your velocity will be distribute in form of many things. કારણ કે પિયર ઉપર સ્ટ્રાઇક થશે, એવી રીતે આ સમજો કે આ તમારું પિયર જ છે, રાઈટ? અને અહીંયાથી તમારો બ્રિજ પાસ થાય છે બીજો, રાઈટ? એન્ડ ધીસ ઇઝ યોર સેકન્ડ પિયર. સો વેન ધ વોટર ઇઝ ફ્લોઇંગ ફ્રોમ ધ ડેમ, એટ ફર્સ્ટ પોઝિશન ધ વેલોસિટી વિલ બી નોર્મલ, બટ વેન ઇટ રીચીસ ટુ ધીસ પર્ટિક્યુલર પોઈન્ટ, ઇટ વિલ સ્ટ્રાઇક, એન્ડ ધેન આફ્ટરવર્ડ ઇટ વિલ ફ્લો ટુવર્ડ ધીસ સેકન્ડ ડાયરેક્શન, સેકન્ડ પિયર. તો એ જગ્યા ઉપર વેલોસિટી સમવોટ વેરી. It will not same, it will vary, either increase or either decrease, right? I'm not saying that it will increase or it will decrease. Whatever the situation on this side, accordingly it may happen, right? Similarly, if I go to the next, so અહીંયા થી કરીશ તો અહીંયા પાછું સ્ટ્રાઇક થશે, then again આગળ, then again fourth point, like way the velocity may vary from point to point. Velocity may be vary from point to point. અને જે જગ્યા ઉપર, જે પોઈન્ટ ઉપર ઇટ વિલ સ્ટ્રાઇક, એટ ધેટ પોઈન્ટ ધ વેલોસિટી વિલ બી મેક્સિમમ. કારણ કે અહીંયા પાણી, અહીંયા જેવું તમારું વોટર અહીંયા સ્ટ્રાઇક થશે, તો આ એરિયામાં તમારું વેલોસિટી ઇટ વિલ બી મેક્સિમમ, રાઈટ? સો ધીસ કેન બી સ્ટડી વિથ ધી હેલ્પ ઓફ લેન્ડ યુઝ, લેન્ડ કવર ઇફેક્ટ. યુ કેન ઓલ્સો ગેટ ધી આઈડિયા અબાઉટ ધી વેજીટેશન, અબાઉટ ધી જીઓલોજીકલ કન્ડિશન ઇન ધીસ પર્ટિક્યુલર ટોપિક, એન્વાયરમેન્ટલ ઇફેક્ટ એન્ડ ધ ડ્રોટ મેનેજમેન્ટ. Now, drought management, already I told you in the previous slide that these are the various topics which can be considered for the sustainable habitat, right? And many works can be carried out, and there are many numbers of softwares also, many number of Excel program also, in which one will be able to carry out the drought management. Now, drought management can be carried out with the help of two parameters. Precipitation as well as the temperature, and based on the precipitation and the temperature, there are numerous number of indices like departure of rainfall, then SPI, standard precipitation index, then SPEI, standard precipitation, evapotranspiration index. Okay, so these are the various indices. These are the various parameters in which you can, you will be able to carry out the drought analysis. And there are four type of drought: agricultural drought, then meteorological drought, socio-economical drought, and miscellaneous drought. Miscellaneous drought is the combination of two droughts, right? Whatever the study which we are discussing, that is the flood, then the land and the drought, everything can, this land use, land cover, climate change, we can consider as a meteorological drought, because we are directly and indirectly connected with the hydrology. Hydrology means occurrence of water, distribution of the water, right? That is the basic science. So when we apply a hydrology, when we apply a science, definitely we can go for a meteorological drought, which are connected with the precipitation as well as the temperature. Now, why study hydrology and water resource engineering? See, already before starting with my lecture, I told you that what is the field of, what is the role, what is the main importance. So the field of hydrology is a crucial area of scientific study and the employment for the people interested in protecting the earth water resources, in combating water pollution, and in providing engineering hydrology. Hydrologists work in conjunction with the work of civil engineering in developing the water resource infrastructure. હવે મારે ડેમ બાંધવું હોય તો હાઇડ્રોલોજિસ્ટ કે કોઈ એન્જિનિયર તો રહેશે જ સાથે, બટ હી વિલ વર્ક ઇન એસોસિએશન વિથ ધ સિવિલ એન્જિનિયર. કારણ કે હાઇડ્રોલોજિસ્ટનું કામ શું છે કે પાણી કેવી રીતનું આવે છે, કઈ રીતે આવે છે, ક્યાંથી અકરન્સ થાય છે, કેવી રીતે ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટ, ધેટ વિલ હેલ્પ અસ. બટ જે બાંધવાનું છે કન્સ્ટ્રક્શન, એ કોણ આપણને મદદ કરશે? સિવિલ એન્જિનિયર. ધેટ્સ વાય ઇટ ઇઝ રિટન ધેટ હાઇડ્રોલોજિસ્ટ વિલ વર્ક ઇન કન્જંક્શન વિથ ધી વર્ક ઓફ સિવિલ એન્જિનિયર્સ ફોર ડેવલપિંગ. કારણ કે આજકાલ તો કેવું છે કે એડવાન્સમેન્ટ ઘણી બધી આવી ગઈ છે, રાઈટ? સો વી હેવ વેરિયસ ટાઈપ ઓફ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટ્સ, ડિજિટલ ઇક્વિપમેન્ટ્સ, વિથ ધી હેલ્પ ઓફ દેટ વી વિલ બી એબલ ટુ ડેવલપ અવર રિસોર્સ ઇન્ફ્રાસ્ટ્રક્ચર. હાઇડ્રોલોજી ઇઝ ધ સાયન્ટિફિક સ્ટડી ઓફ ધી ઇફેક્ટ, પ્રોપર્ટી એન્ડ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુશન ઓફ ધ વોટર ઓન ધ અર્થ સર્ફેસ, ઇન ધ સોઇલ, રોક સ્ટ્રક્ચર્સ, એન્ડ ઓલ્સો ઓન ધી અનસ્ટ્રક્ચર. નાવ ઇન વિચ વે ધ પર્સન વિલ ગેટ ધી એમ્પ્લોયમેન્ટ? તમને કઈ કઈ જુદી જુદી ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશન્સમાં, કાં તો કઈ કઈ જગ્યાએ તમને એમ્પ્લોયમેન્ટ મળવાના ચાન્સીસ છે? તો ધેર આર ફોર સર્ટન બ્રાન્ચીસ. એક વોટર રિસોર્સ એન્જિનિયરને સૌથી પહેલા, બે મેં તમને કીધા, એ તો તમને ખબર જ હશે કે ભાઈ વોટર રિસોર્સ બનેલા છે તો વોટર રિસોર્સની ફિલ્ડ પર અમને મળશે. આઈ વિલ શો યુ વન ઇમેજ. રિસેન્ટલી વન ઓફ માય ફ્રેન્ડ હુ ઇઝ સેટલ્ડ એટ કેનેડા, સો હી હેઝ અપ્લાઇડ એટ સો મેની કંપનીઝ વિચ આર પ્યોરલી રિલેટેડ ટુ ધ વોટર, રાઈટ? So he appeared for the interview in 8 to 9 companies, and recently in the last company, Purely Water, je humna apne discuss kiya che, any company che, right? I will just show you that what are the various post of that, right? He has shared me one screenshot of that, and he told me that he is not selected, but the thing is, in the Canada they have kept the kept vacant, that post is vacant till date also. If they don't get any employee, experienced employee, they will keep the post vacant, right? So as a water resource engineer, there are lots of scope. If you are interested for the consultant, then also the very broad scope, hydrology broad scope, you can go for a flood modeling, flood analysis, water distribution network, rainfall runoff modeling. Agriculture, if we talk about the agriculture, then you need to go for irrigation schemes, micro network irrigation, drip irrigation system, jene gujarati ma kya tapak sinchai paddhati. And civil engineer na andar evu chhe ke ghani badi field, R&B, irrigation, Narmada Kalpsar, GWSSB, right? Then VASMO, WEPCOS, a baddhi vastu civil engineering ma aave na baddha ma aave, water resource ma bhi aave. WEPCOS is a purely field of water resource engineering, right? Now I am just sharing that one peak which I just want to show you that which type of post we have. Just I am sharing the screen, 1 minute. Okay, hope my screen is visible. See, this is one photo. Okay, now you can see from starting, senior water resource engineer, water resource technician, water resource assistant, water management data specialist, senior water resource second person, right? Water resource project coordinator, then water control structural engineer, water resource project specialist, water resource project specialist. See, they want these people, right? Now in this post, one of my friend had applied, he appeared for the interview. At that time, each and everything, they were impressed. Yes, you are aware of this, you are aware of this. But when they selected this, you can see he is not selected and they kept the post vacant. And in that, this is one government organization only in which they have one project, and that project can be run by this many number of people. So you can see it is written project coordinator, project specialist, technician, assistant. So you can see the how many posts we have if you do the research in the water resource era, right? એટલે બધાને એવું હોય ને કે ભાઈ હું અગર આ વોટર રિસોર્સ એન્જિનિયરિંગ કરીશ તો મને શું એમાં ફાયદા થશે, વોટ આર ધી વેરિયસ સ્કોપ ઓફ ધેટ. સો ધીસ આર ધ સ્કોપ, નોટ ઓનલી આઉટ ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા, હિયર ઓલસો, ઇન ઇન્ડિયા ઓલસો, બટ વી નીડ ટુ ડુ સમ એફર્ટ્સ, રાઈટ? રીડિંગ અ ન્યૂઝ પેપર, કઈ કઈ જગ્યાએ કન્સલ્ટન્સી ચાલે છે, કઈ કઈ જગ્યાએ શું કામ ચાલે છે, આ બધું આપણે જોવું પડે, રાઈટ? નાઉ what is the hydrologic system? Now there are two things. One is hydraulic system and another is the hydrologic system. Hydrologic covers the work related to the precipitation, stream flow, groundwater, then temperature. આ બધી વસ્તુ hydrologic માં આવી જાય. Hydraulic means that is also related to the water. But if you have studied flow through pipes, minor losses, major losses, then viscosity, આ બધી વસ્તુ hydraulics માં આવે. તમારો fluid mechanics subject પકડી લો. In diploma, the fluid mechanics subject is called as a hydraulics. But when you go to the BE, UG level, the subject name is fluid mechanics. But હવે GTUA curriculum ના અંદર જે change કર્યું, તેમાં એ લોકો શું આપ્યું છે? Fluid mechanics and hydraulics. Right? So, in hydraulics, one will be able to talk, one will be able to understand the idea of pipe flows, right? You will be able to get the idea about the channel, open channel, right? This way, one, this is the two system, that is the hydrologic and hydraulic. Now, hydrologic, in hydrologic, we have a very long-term monitoring. હવે વરસાદનું મોસમ હોય તો હવે હું તમને એમ કહું, ચાલ તું મને એનાલિસિસ કરી ના, તો તું બે દિવસના વરસાદથી આપણે એનાલિસિસ કરી શકીએ? ના કરી શકીએ. We need to monitor for a long term. મારી પાસે 10 દિવસનો હોવો જોઈએ, 15 દિવસનો હોવો જોઈએ, 1 મહિનાનો હોવો જોઈએ, like that. Then and then I will have some outcome that this way the prediction of the rainfall can be carried out. Stream flow, that is the discharge. Groundwater levels, I told you salinity, seawater intrusion with the help of mode flow, you will be able to carry it out. And there are certain losses which you have to consider, which I told you, minor loss, major loss in the pipe. Similarly, here also you will be able to get some losses that you need to verify it, and you need to tackle that loss and solve the losses. So according to the study of hydrology, river is a natural stream in a channel. River na tame banavi che ke na me banavi che, it is a natural stream. Ha, yes, you can do a minor distributary channels, matlab pani ne divert karva mate tame nani tributaries banavi shako, but you will not able to design, or you will not able to do the newly constructed river. E jate natural ach che. Ha, you can change the you can change the alignment. તમે અલાઇનમેન્ટ ચેન્જ કરી શકો છો કે હા, ધીસ વે ધી રિવર ચેનલ કેન બી અલાઇન્ડ. એટલે સમજો કે આઈ વિલ શો યુ, હા, સી ધીસ ઇઝ માય રિવર અલાઇનમેન્ટ, રાઈટ? લાઈક ધીસ. તો તમે આ અલાઇનમેન્ટને ચેન્જ કરી શકો છો, રાઈટ? ઇફ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ ગો ફોર અ ટ્રિબ્યુટરીઝ, સો યુ કેન ડ્રો અ ટ્રિબ્યુટરીઝ, બરાબર? પણ પછી તમે એમ કહો કે ના, હું અહીંયા એક નવી નદી જેની બાજુમાં પેરેલલ બનાવી દઉં, સો ધેટ ઇઝ નોટ ઇન અવર કેસ, રાઈટ? So the new stream reaches whatever the new stream which you are going to adopt, that is the tributaries, it should be dynamically stable and should have a geomorphic property. Geomorphic property means it should have a, means it is free from the obstructions, then the area, geological condition, આ બધી વસ્તુ આપણે જોવી પડે, then and then we will be able to carry out the new work. That are the characteristics of the natural scene. Now, as I said, that there is a lots of advancement in the computer technology, right? So, with the rapid advancement in the computer technology and the research in the numerical techniques, various 1D, 2D models based on the hydraulic routing, as well as I'm adding hydrologic routing, have been developed in the past for the flood forecasting and the inundation mapping. And the study which I am going to discuss with you, that is the carried out on the hydrodynamically model, which will be able to predict the flood level. I told you that તમે ઘરે બેઠા બેઠા તમે flood level predict કરી શકો કે આ જગ્યાએ આવી શકે, આ જગ્યાએ ના આવી શકે, બધું તમે કરી શકો. Hydrological data can also help us to prepare and plan for an extreme event by identifying where the risks are highest. આપણને hydrological ના data, એટલે hydrology ના data, river ના data છે કે પછી રેનફોલ ના ડેટા છે કે ફ્લડ ના, એના પરથી આપણે એક પ્લાન બનાવી શકીએ, એક્શન પ્લાન બનાવી શકીએ. જ્યાં જ્યાં હેવી રેનફોલ થતો હોય ત્યાં જે એરિયાને લો લાઈંગ એરિયા કન્સિડર કરીએ એને. નાઉ લો લાઈંગ એરિયા, વોટ ડુ બાય લો લાઈંગ એરિયા, જેને કહેવાય નીચાણ વાળો વિસ્તાર. તો વેન એવર દેર ઇઝ અ હેવી રેનફોલ, ઇફ ધ વોટર ઇઝ રિલીઝ ફ્રોમ ધ ડેમ, તો તમે જોયું હશે કે પાણી ફ્લડ આવે છે નીચાણ વાળા વિસ્તારમાં, બહુ જલ્દી ફ્લડ આવી જાય છે. કેમ? ઇફ ધ ઇવન આફ્ટર ધ ગેટ્સ આર ક્લોઝ, તમારા ગેટ્સ, જે ડેમના ગેટ્સ તમે બંધ કરો છો, તો બી તમારું પાણી કેમ આવી જાય છે, કેમ ફ્લડ આવે? બીકોઝ ઓફ બેક વોટર. એ જે નીચાણવાળા વિસ્તારમાં જે ફ્લડ આવે છે, એ ફ્લડનું નામ છે બેક વોટર. એન્ડ ધેટ ઇઝ ધી, જે પાણી તમે ગેટ બંધ કરી દીધા, પાણી અંદર છે તો શું થશે? આગળ એને જવા જ ના મળે, તો વોટ વિલ હેપન? ઇટ વિલ કમ આઉટ. એટલે એને કહેવાય બેક વોટર. એટલે તમે જોયું હશે કે નીચાણવાળા વિસ્તારમાં શું થાય, જનરલી ઇટ ઇઝ ફ્લડેડ, બરાબર? એટલે જે ગટરનું પાણી હોય એને બહાર વોશઆઉટ કરવા માટે સ્ટ્રોમ ડ્રેન આઉટલેટ ના ખુલ્લા હોય તો શું થાય? ધેર વિલ બી ધ ચાન્સીસ ઓફ ફ્લડ ઇન ધ લો લાઈંગ એરિયા. આઈ એમ ટોકિંગ ઓર ધ સ્પેસિફિકલી ઓન ધ લો લાઈંગ એરિયા, નોટ ફોર ધ એરિયા વિચ ઇઝ ઓલરેડી ડેવલપ, રાઈટ? એન્ડ ડે ટુ ડે ધ હાઇડ્રોલોજિકલ ડેટા ઇઝ યુઝ ટુ બેટર મેનેજ અવર વોટર રિસોર્સિસ ઇન વેઝ, વેરિયસ વેઝ વિચ સુટ અવર ઇકોનોમિકલ એન્ડ એન્વાયરમેન્ટલ નીડ્સ. Now, what are the basic requirements for the hydrological studies? હવે મારે ઈચ્છા થઈ ગઈ કે ચલો હવે આપણે હાઇડ્રોલોજિકલ સ્ટડીઝ કરીએ, તો વોટ આર બેઝિક રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ? સો વન ઇઝ ધી હાઇડ્રોલોજી એનાલિસિસ મેથડ. ડેટા રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ વેરી વિથ ધ મેથડ યુઝ. હવે તમે એમ કહો કે ના હું આ સોફ્ટવેર વાપરીશ, તો એ સોફ્ટવેરમાં એના ડેટા જોઈશે, બરાબર? સેકન્ડ પર્સન એવું કહેશે કે ના હું આ સોફ્ટવેર વાપરીશ, તો એની ડેટાની રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ એના મેથડ પ્રમાણે ડિફરન્ટ હોય. કોઈમાં ડિસ્ચાર્જની જરૂરિયાત હોય, હવે ડિસ્ચાર્જમાં બી અલગ અલગ પ્રકાર આવે. 1 hour discharge, 3 hour discharge, 6 hour discharge, 9 hour discharge, 12 hour discharge, 24 hour discharge, એટલે daily discharge, monthly discharge, right? So you can see in some software if they want a 3 hour discharge, right? હવે આ જે અવર છે, તો you all are aware, those who have studied the hydrology subject, કે હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ આપણો આવતો હોય છે, right? So that is a 3 hour hydrograph, 6 hour hydrograph, 9 hour hydrograph, 12 hour hydrograph, like that. So the data requirement is vary with respect to method. Geographic and the geometric property of the watershed, એટલે કે એની size કેવી છે, એનો shape કેવો છે, એનો catchment નો area કેટલો છે, આ બધી વસ્તુ તમારે એની requirement છે. Land use, natural storage, vegetation cover, soil property information, already I told you, in one word it is a geological condition, right? Then description of the drainage features of the watershed, rainfall observation and the statistics of the precipitation. Now, what is the research objective? If anybody is interested to carry out the assessment of the flood or the prediction of the flood, right? So I think Abhishek Sapre is also have joined, so he might be aware of this, all these things, right? So what I am going to discuss with you today, one of the case study of Surat city, that is a flood having the area of 11 kilometer, which is passing from the Sardar Bridge to Magdala Bridge. Right, and I will show you that what will be the situation, right? If I release the water up to 4 lakh cusec, 5 lakh cusec, 6 lakh cusec, 7 lakh cusec, 8 lakh cusec, and 9 lakh cusec, what will be the situation of the Surat city people? Kitlo area flooded thase, e hu tamne last ma batavis. I have. Tame jorso ne khali, you just have to focus on the image. Automatic you will get the idea that if I release huge amount of water, there will be the situation of the flood. So the software which I will show you, that is the Hackers, that is the Hydraulic Engineering Center River Analysis System, which is freely open source software. The first version of this software is published in 1995, and recently Hackers 6.0 published by US Army recently with addition of some of the tools. Pella jare version 4 avelo tu jare first version, that is in 1995, at that time there are no and there is no any tool in which we can be able to carry out the DEM. We can add import the DEM, e badu apne nata kari shakta, but nowadays by adding such tool, by adding such extension, you will be able to carry out so many things. Then to determine the adequacy of the existing section, એટલે river ઉપર જે cross sections already છે એની adequacy we can able to check, and to recommend the measure. હવે after doing all this thing, you will be able to give some measures કે હા આમાં આના લીધે આવું થઈ શકે, આના લીધે આવું થઈ શકે, આના લીધે આવું થઈ શકે, એ આઉટ પ્રે કરી શકીએ. To assure the safe flood prevention, you can prepare an action plan also કે ભાઈ આ જગ્યા પર flood ને મારે રોકવા માટે મારે શું કરવું જોઈએ, right? So this is the study area which I am going to discuss with you. I am not going into depth because all are aware, and this everything information is available on the Google. This is the zone wise population, the central zone. Surat city is divided into 7 zone, right? 1 minute. Okay, this is the as I said now, that Surat city is divided into 7 zones. This is the zone. Now data collection, see data collection, if you have a contact, agar tamne koi odakto hase to tamaro data collection nu kaam bahu sehlai thi pati jase in a very easy manner, but if you don't have any contact, then it is a very much tedious work, because to collect a data is a toughest job, right? અને અત્યારની સ્થિતિમાં તો બહુ ટફેસ્ટ કહેવાય. તમે ત્યાં જાઓ, લેટર આપો, મળશે સાહેબ કે નહીં, પહેલી તો વસ્તુ એ છે. ગવર્મેન્ટમાં તમે કોઈ બી જગ્યાએ જશો, હાઇડ્રોલિક ડિપાર્ટમેન્ટ, એસએમસી ઓર ઇરિગેશન ડિપાર્ટમેન્ટ, તો પહેલા તો સાહેબ છે કે નહીં એમને પૂછવું પડે કે ભાઈ કેટલા વાગે તમે આવશો, લાઈક ધેટ. ઓકે, એન્ડ પહેલી વિઝિટમાં તો ડેટા મળવા મુશ્કેલ જ છે અગર તમારી પાસે કોન્ટેક્ટ ના હોય તો. બટ ઇફ યુ વેન્ટ, ઇફ યુ વિઝિટેડ the irrigation office or the CWC office with the reference of some person, to tamne tarat ne tarat ne at a time at a glance you will get the data, right? So field data is needed, which were collected from the hydraulic department of Surat Municipal Corporation. Total length of the modeled reach that I will show you, this is my modeled reach. See, I am just highlighting, this is my modeled reach. Why modeled reach? Karan ke aa area ma hu kaam karvano chu, and my upstream is here, and this is my downstream. My upstream is Sardar Bridge, my downstream is Magdalla Bridge. There is no any bridge in between this, but ahiya che maro ek pehlo bridge ahiya, ane aa me hamna je tamne study batadu chu, it is of before the construction of the cable state bridge and that Pal Umra bridge, barabar, karan ke cable state bridge bhi have bani gyo che ane Pal Umra bridge bhi bani gyo che. So if you are interested to do work on this, so you will get very 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 good result. કારણ કે હવે તમને એ બ્રિજ ની ઇફેક્ટ ભી દેખાશે આમાં, રાઈટ? સમજો કે એક બ્રિજ અહીંયા છે અને એક બ્રિજ અહીંયા છે, તો તમને આની ઇફેક્ટ ભી તમારા ક્રોસ સેક્શન્સ ઉપર ખબર પડશે, આની ઇફેક્ટ ભી તમને ખબર પડશે, રાઈટ? સો માય અપસ્ટ્રીમ ઇઝ ધ સરદાર બ્રિજ એન્ડ માય ડાઉનસ્ટ્રીમ ઇઝ ધ મંગદલા બ્રિજ એન્ડ ધ રિવર ઇઝ ફ્લોઇંગ ફ્રોમ ધીસ. ધીસ રેડ લાઈન ઇન્ડિકેટ ધી ક્રોસ સેક્શન્સ નંબર, રાઈટ? ઇન માય પ્રીવિયસ સ્લાઇડ આઈ ટોલ્ડ ના that 11 km. So this is my 11 km reach from here, this yellow point to yellow point, and total 49 cross sections are there. એટલે આ જે રેડ લાઈન જે છે, this 1 2 3 right now it is not 49, but for your example, for explaining, I have just drawn 30 or 31 lines are there. So here there are 49 cross sections, and each cross section, એટલે એક cross section ના અંદર 80 readings હશે. 80 કેટલા? 80. હવે એવા સમજો કે 50 ક્રોસ સેક્શન લઈ લો તો તમારે કેટલા રીડિંગ નાખવા પડશે? 4000. 4000 readings you have to import in a software. Then and well, software will tell you, okay, yes, your area is safe. Right. So this is the upstream, this is the downstream. Then detailed cross-section of the river Tapi showing the bed and the bank level at an average interval of 200 to 250. Like a cross-section and bija cross-section vachche no distance. Means this and this. A banne vachche no antar keto 200 ka to 250. Right. Now, map of all the cross sections and the map of the study area were obtained from the Surat Athwa zone office, right? Then detailed longitudinal cross sections were collected from the irrigation department of the Surat Irrigation Circle. Past flood data collected from the research, some of the research paper and the flood cell of Surat. Detail of storm drain outlet. Ano su kaam che me tamne pehla j kidu ke je low lying area ase ne ema storm drain outlet tamare check karani ke whether it is properly maintained or not. Whether it is properly working or not, કારણ કે એના ગેટ્સ અગર સમજી લો કે વપરાતા ના હોય અને ગેટ્સ બનના બંધ હોય તો તમને બેક વોટર નાથી બી ફ્લડ આવી શકે. સો ધીસ ઓલ ડેટા વેર કલેક્ટેડ ફ્રોમ ધ સુરત ઇરિગેશન સર્કલ. ટોપ આરએલ ઓફ લેફ્ટ સાઈડ એન્ડ ધ રાઈટ સાઈડ ઓફ ધ સ્ટડી એરિયા આર કલેક્ટેડ ફ્રોમ ધ સુરત. નાઉ વોટ ઇઝ ધ આરએલ લેફ્ટ સાઈડ એન્ડ રાઈટ સાઈડ? સમજો કે આ તમારું રિવર છે, રાઈટ? તો આ રિવરના જ્યારે રિવર તમારી પતશે તો ત્યાં એક વોલ બનાવેલી છે, રિટેનિંગ વોલ, રાઈટ? તો કોઈ કોઈ જગ્યાએ હશે ને કોઈ કોઈ જગ્યાએ નહીં હશે. તો જ્યાં નહીં હશે ત્યાં નેચરલ જ હશે, રાઈટ? તો એનું રીડિંગ સમજો કે 2.5 છે, 2.5. નાઉ વેન આઈ એમ કન્સ્ટ્રક્ટિંગ ધ રિટેનિંગ વોલ તો એની હાઈટ વધશે. એટલે હાઈટ વાળે સમજો કે હું 3 મીટરની બીજી બનાવું છું, બરાબર? તો એ જગ્યા ઉપર મારું કેટલું થશે એનું આરએલ? 5.5. બીકોઝ આઈ નીડ ટુ કન્સિડર ફ્રોમ ધીસ એઝ વેલ એઝ ધીસ. આની ઉપર બીજી 3 મીટરની વોલ બનાવીને, સો ધેટ ઇફ ધ વોટર ઇઝ ફ્લોઈંગ ફ્રોમ ધ ડેમ ઇટ વિલ નોટ ગોઈંગ ટુ ઓવરટોપ, રાઈટ? નાઉ વોટ ઇઝ ધ મેથોડોલોજી? સી, મેથોડોલોજી ઇઝ એડોપ્ટેડ ઇન 3 પાર્ટ: હાઇડ્રોલિક, યુનિફોર્મ ફ્લો કોમ્પિટિશન એન્ડ કમ્પેરિંગ ધી સેક્શન્સ. નાઉ ફર્સ્ટ વી ગો ફોર અ પાર્ટ એ, દેટ ઇઝ ધ હાઇડ્રોલિક મોડલિંગ. That is the Hacker Software Hydrologic Engineering Center River Analysis System, which is developed by US Army Corporation of Engineers in 1995. First version is released. That is the 4. Now I am not going into the history. This is the modeling system that what one will be able to carry out the things. Now there are certain equations in every software. If you go for a structural software, STEPRO, if you go for a STUD, if you go for a ETABS, if you go for a SAP, if you go for a mode flow, to koi ne badha software na da kai ne ke equations hoye che, barabar? In each and every software there are some equation, but apne shu karta hoye che generally, we are just incorporating the data, we are entering the data and we will get the output. We are not bothered by which equation, by which way, by which assumptions the means the output will be occurred, right? So these are the some equations. This is the energy equation, that is y plus z plus alpha 2 v2 upon 2g plus he. He is the energy loss, energy head loss. This is the continuity equation, which is most important as the water is released from the dam, which can be called as a q, that is q is equals to a1 v1, right? Then next is the energy equation, which I told you, flow resistance equation and Manning's n, right? Manning's n is used in this study to check the bed material, and accordingly with the help of bed material one will be able to carry out the flood modeling and the flood analysis, and one will be able to check whether my bed material are having a which particle size distribution, whether D50, D45, D84, like that. Now how the data to be analyzed, right? That we can discuss over here. How the data can, this is the one particular window of the Hackers. This is the open source software one will be able to download in its from its website. So if I, this is the main window of the Hackers. This is the Hackers 4.1.0. You need to go for a file option. And these are some of the program features which I will explain you, that these are the input, all are the input and these are the output. So if you enter the channel geometry, you will get the cross sections and the profile. If you enter the flow and the boundary condition, you will get a computed rating curve and the 3D cross sections. And this is the one another topic, that is a scour. You can find out the effect of scour, or you can say analysis of the scour on the bridge. એટલે મેં તમને જે બોલે કે એક્ઝામ્પલ બતાવ્યો, લાઈક અગેન આઈ એમ શેરિંગ યુ, સી ધીસ ઇઝ એક્ઝામ્પલ. મારું આ બ્રિજ ઉપર દેર ઇઝ વન આ રિવર ના આ સાઈડ ઉપર દેર ઇઝ વન બ્રિજ રાઈટ નાવ ઇફ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ કન્સ્ટ્રક્ટ વન મોર બ્રિજ ઓન ધીસ રાઈટ સો આઈ નીડ ટુ ગો ફોર અ સ્કાવર સ્ટડી દેટ ઇફ આઈ કન્સ્ટ્રક્ટ ધ બ્રિજ એની ઇફેક્ટ ઓન ધ એક્ઝિસ્ટિંગ બ્રિજ દેટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો વન ઓફ ધ સ્ટડી બરાબર હવે કેટલા ડિસ્ટન્સ ઉપર હું બીજો પેરેલલ બ્રિજ બનાવી શકું એ બી તમે સ્ટડી કરી શકો છો મીન્સ ડ્યુઅલ બ્રિજિસ ધીસ ઇઝ માય એક્ઝિસ્ટિંગ બ્રિજ ઓલરેડી નાવ ઇફ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ એડ અ ડ્યુઅલ બ્રિજ ઓર ઇફ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ કન્સ્ટ્રક્ટ અ ડ્યુઅલ બ્રિજ તો એના માટે મારે આ જોવું પડશે કે ભાઈ કે આ જગ્યા ઉપર અગર હું બ્રિજ કન્સ્ટ્રક્ટ કરું તો વેધર ઇટ મે ગેટ એફેક્ટ ઓન માય એક્ઝિસ્ટિંગ બ્રિજ ઓર નોટ ટેક ધી એક્ઝામ્પલ ઓફ મહારાષ્ટ્ર પુણે હાઈવે દેર ઇઝ વન ફેલિયર ઓફ અ બ્રિજ ઇટ ઇઝ બીકોઝ ઓફ ધી અનઇવન સ્ટ્રક્ચરલ કન્ડિશન ઓફ ધી એડિશનલ બ્રિજ એ લોકોને ખબર નથી કે ભાઈ હું આ જગ્યા ઉપર એડિશનલ બ્રિજ બનાવીશ તો એનો જે બી લોડ પડશે એ આ સહન કરી શકશે આના ઉપર જે બી સ્કાવરની ડેપ્થ હશે સહન કરી શકશે દેટ વી નીડ ટુ ચેક રાઈટ સો દેટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો વન ઓફ ધ ટોપિક સ્કાવર એટ ધ બ્રિજિસ એન્ડ દિસ વિલ ગીવ યુ ધ આઉટપુટ ઇન ફોર્મ ઓફ ટેબ્યુલર એન્ડ ધ એરર ઇફ એની એરર અકર ઇન ધ સોફ્ટવેર દેટ વિલ શો યુ Now, when I go to the file option, I will open the flood, that is the save project as. Once I will save project as, the computer will ask me that which, on which unit you want to work. Computer, by default, it will give us the US customer unit, but we need to go for an option and we need to change the unit system from US to SI because we are using mini metric system. That's why we need to select the SI system. Then afterwards, what are the various data which are to be incorporated into the software? So one is the geometric data. What do you mean by geometric data? That I will explain you. See, in geometric data, you need to insert the cross-sectional data. Cross-sectional data means the data which having reduced level, or you can say in other words, elevation and the station distance. Station distance means કે એક ક્રોસ સેક્શન થી બીજા ક્રોસ સેક્શન વચ્ચેનું અંતર કેટલું છે રાઈટ બરાબર એટલે એ તમને મળશે પછી મારો પહેલો ક્રોસ સેક્શન ક્યાં સ્ટાર્ટ થાય છે બીજો ક્રોસ સેક્શન ક્યાં ખતમ થાય છે એ બધી વસ્તુના ડેટા તમારે આના અંદર જોઈશે સેમાં જ્યોમેટ્રિક ડેટાના અંદર મીન્સ આઈ વિલ શો યુ દેટ ઓલ્સો ઇન ધી ઇમેજ ઓલ્સો ઓકે નાવ નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ અ રીચ લેન્ડ આ મારી અહીંયા રિવર અહીંયાથી અહીંયા સુધી સ્ટાર્ટ થાય છે સો વોટ ઇઝ માય રીચ લેન્ડ યસ આઈ થિંક વન ક્વેશ્ચન Someone has raised the hand. Yes, if you want to ask anything. Okay. If anybody wants to ask any question, you can write in the chat box or we can also discuss at the end of the session. Okay, so reach length. So what is the length of my reach from starting point to ending? As I said, for my study, it is 11 kilometer. It is 11 kilometer, right? So the reach length is distance between cross sections, right? This is the whole reach length. Now, if I want to go for this, what is the distance between this 200 to 250, right? Steady flow data. Now, steady flow data, it means the peak for discharge data. If I want to go for a steady flow analysis, then I need to go for, or I want to use only peak discharge. Peak discharge means say take the example of 2006 flood of Surat city to a j duration ma jare aavelo tyare peak discharge je hato 9.09 lakh cubic that I need to consider for the steady flow analysis Surat city faces the 31 times of flood 31 and if you can say before the construction of dam I think 15 floods and after the construction of dam 15 floods so say, by combining both 30 or 31 times Surat city faced the flood Flood conveyance performance, as I said, that past flow discharge I will get from the CWC Surat also and from the drainage division. Now, geometric data. I click on this particular window and when I click on that, this type of window will going to be appear on my screen. Right. Now, when I have this screen, I need to draw a river. My computer ne kyu padse ki hamari river che. So, I click on river reach. When I click on this river reach, You can see, I will draw like this. Now, mari rite koi bhi rite draw kari shako like this, right? So this is my river. Then I have to give the name. I wrote Magdala and Nehru Bridge, right? This one and two still not completed. Atyare khali hu river bataru chu software ne ki amari river chhe. Now this one and two indicates the cross section. This one. Now I need to go for a adding of cross section. So pehla hu ane geometric data ne save karis, right? after saying that, now I will go for a adding of cross section. Now you can see how the cross sections are to be added. I told you 80 number of reading will be there. So 0 thi line 830 tame ganatri karso, so it might be 70 to 80 readings. These readings I have to import in my software, that is a hacker software. So aa khali ek ch cross section evi rite apne mari study na andar ketla je 49. So I need to do the same process for all the 49. Right, this is the original cross sections which I will get from, which means which I got from the Surat Municipal Corporation. So when you enter this data, when you enter this all data, you will get this type of cross section, and you must have to check whether the section which is drawn into the software, it is same which is collected from the SMC or not. Agar kase wrong ase ta tamne niche dekha se. अगर आप नीचे देखा तो तुम तरत चेक कर सो भाई आज जगह पर कितनी है, तो के -1, चलो चेक करिए, राइट, लाइक दिस, ओके, 1 मिनट. Okay, so this is the cross sections. Now if I enter this data, right, if I enter this data, this will be the cross sections which I will which I show you, and this same cross section you will get from the SMC. This you will get from the SMC, right? Now enter the cross sectional data. Now how to enter the cross sections, that I will show you, that when I click on this cross section, so this type of window will be appear on the screen, this, right? Now in that, go to option this, right, and click on a add a new cross section. When you click on a add a new cross section, you will be able to enter the data. Now you can see the data 025.078, you can see 027.078. so this data, this way station means, હવે તમને આનો એક એક્ઝામ્પલ આપો કે તમે સર્વિંગ ભણ્યા હશો તો સર્વિંગ ના થિયોડોલાઇટ સર્વે આપણે કરતા હતા, તેમાં એક છોકરો સ્ટાફ લઈને ઉભો હોય, બીજો થિયોડોલાઇટ હોય અને ત્રીજો રીડિંગ લખતો હોય, રાઈટ? તો હિયર આઈ એમ સ્ટેન્ડિંગ વિથ અ સ્ટાફ એટ અ ઝીરો પોઝિશન, રાઈટ? વન ઓફ માય પર્સન ઇઝ ટેકિંગ ધ રીડિંગ ફ્રોમ ધ થિયોડોલાઇટ એન્ડ અનધર પર્સન ઇઝ રાઇટિંગ ડાઉન ધ રીડિંગ. સો ધેટ રીડિંગ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ ઇટ ઇઝ અ એલિવેશન, ધીસ 25.078. નાઉ આઈ શિફ્ટેડ માય સ્ટાફ ફ્રોમ 0 મીટર ડિસ્ટન્સ ટુ 10 મીટર. You can see I am at a 10 meter. So tyare su reading ayu 14.6, like that, right? Now I will show you that what this interpretation says, right? This is station, that is I am standing at 0 point. When I change to 0 to 10, when I change to 10 to 20, like that. Now what is this downstream reach length? This says that what is the distance of first cross section. See, this is my river. 1 minute. It is. Okay. Yes. This is my river. This is my first cross section. Okay. Now, what is my reach length for first cross section? It will be 0. Thank you. That's our starting point. So, it will be 0. So, 0 LOB. LOB means leftover bank, means left side. Channel means, jyan pani tamne dekha the river nu A. And ROB means right overbank, right? So it will be 0. But when I switch over to next cross section, I need to enter the data from this to this is 200 or 250, whatever. Bra, vary thatu hoy, right? Next is the Manning's N value. I told you flow resistance equation, I told you that is the Manning's N. 1 minute. Flow resistance equation, that is the Manning's N value, and Manning's N value can be get from there is one book, Flow in Open Channel. In Flow in Open Channel, chapter number 2, page number 25, you will get the details of the bed material. કે અગર સમજો કે તમારું ગ્રેવલ છે તો આટલી વેલ્યુ લેવાની, અગર સમજો તમારું સેન્ડ ટાઈપ મટીરિયલ છે તો આટલી વેલ્યુ લેવાની, લાઈક ધેટ. એન્ડ બેઝડ ઓન ધેટ યુ વિલ બી એબલ ટુ સિલેક્ટ ધીસ મેનિંગ્સ વેલ્યુ. એન્ડ નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ ધ મેઇન ચેનલ બેંક સ્ટેશન. વોટ ઇટ સેઝ મેઇન ચેનલ, એટલે મારે કોમ્પ્યુટરને જાણકાર કરવી પડશે કે ભાઈ મારો સ્ટેશન ઝીરો થી સ્ટાર્ટ થાય છે અને પતે છે ક્યાં, તો 8:30. This is my ending point and this is my starting point. So I have to inform my computer or software that my starting point is 0 and ending point is 8:30. Right? So, and last is the contraction and expansion. So, ena mate tamare kashu karan jarur nathi. If you are going for a steady flow, this will be the constant value. But yes, I discuss one case study. Aavi ek case study tamari jo discuss karali, river meandering. તો રિવર મેન્ડરિંગ જ્યારે તમે લો તમારી રિવરને, ત્યારે આ વેલ્યુ વેરી થશે. બીકોઝ ઇટ હેવિંગ સમ લોસિસ, કોન્ટ્રાક્શન લોસ એન્ડ એક્સપાન્શન લોસિસ, રાઈટ. નાવ ઇફ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ એડ અનધર ક્રોસ સેક્શન, તો ફરીથી ઓપ્શનમાં જાઓ, એડ અ ન્યુ ક્રોસ સેક્શન એન્ડ ડુ ધ હોલ પ્રોસેસ અગેન વિચ આઈ ડિસ્કસ. બરાબર, પહેલો ક્રોસ સેક્શન કરવા માટે બી ઓપ્શનમાં જવાનું, એડ અ ન્યુ ક્રોસ સેક્શન, એટલે તમારો પહેલો ક્રોસ સેક્શન નખાઈ ગયો. ફરીથી નાખવા માટે અગેન યુ હેવ ટુ ગો ફોર ઓપ્શન એન્ડ ગો ફોર એડ અ ન્યુ ક્રોસ સેક્શન. વન્સ યુ વિલ એન્ટર ઓલ ધ ડેટા ધેટ યુ વિલ ગેટ સચ ટાઈપ ઓફ ક્રોસ સેક્શન્સ. નાઉ નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ અ સ્ટેડી ફ્લો ડેટા, નેક્સ્ટ સ્ટેપ. હવે એમાં જરા, યસ, એની ક્વેશ્ચન? Yes, one of the question we have in the chat box, difference between the mic 11 and hack RMS or HMS and which is the better for simulation. See, hack HMS, I think it is HMS, I think, or RMS, whatever. See, hack HMS is a freely open source software and mic 11 is not a freely open source software. So this is one of the difference. And if you can see the advantage of licensed software, that if you are purchasing a licensed software, then they will give us many number of tools to use, and in freely open source software some tools are restricted, right? And for better simulation I can suggest mic 11 is the better. Okay, kaan ke jo licensed version tumhe lesho ne to it will give you the proper idea. There are some add-on tools also in the mic 11 software, because mic having so many features, mic 11, mic 21, mic 31, mic urban, mic flood, mic C, right? Tamara rainfall runoff modeling karu hai to bhi mic software use kari shako cho, flood forecasting karu hai to bhi mic use kari shako cho, right? Ave aa je hack HMS che ke RMS I am not aware, but hack HMS is mainly used for the rainfall runoff modeling, not for the flood, right? And if you are talking about the hackers, then in hackers you will be able to carry out the flood assessment, flood evaluation, sediment transport capacity, water quality modeling, then dam break analysis, scour depth, everything you will be carried out with the use of this hackers. Similarly, same thing you will be apply for a mic also. And mic 11 says one dimensional, mic 21 two dimensional, mic 31 three dimensional. This way you will be able. So better software I can suggest, that is the mic, right? Because it having so many add-on tools in that. And you all are aware that agar apne koi license vastu laiye to license na andar apne je suvidha free ma na mare ama mari shake, right? So I am talking about the add a new cross section. So this way one will be able to add the cross section. Now we go for a first analysis, that is a steady flow analysis. I hope it is clear to everyone. I think Nikun sir or any other participant, I hope it is clear to everyone up to this particular point. Now I will go for a steady flow analysis. So in that, two options are there, edit and run. So first I need to incorporate the data, enter the data, and then I will run the analysis. So for edit, first I will go for edit. So once I click on edit, this type of window will be appear on my screen, this first window, right? In that it is written enter or number of profile. Now if you have 32,000 discharge data, તમારી પાસે 32,000 પીક ડિસ્ચાર્જ ડેટા હોય એટલું તમે એનાલિસિસ એક જ વખતમાં કરી શકો. પણ કોઈ ભી જગ્યા પર કોઈ ભી સ્ટેટ કોઈ ભી સિટી કોઈ ભી રાજ્ય લઈ લો તમારે કોઈની પાસે આટલા 32000 ક્યુસેક 32000 ના પીક ડિસ્ચાર્જ હશે જ નહીં મેક્સિમમ દે હેવ 40 ઓર 50 જે રીતે સુરતમાં મેં તમને કીધું કે 31 ટાઈમ એટલે તમને 31 પીક ડિસ્ચાર્જ મળી શકે રાઈટ તો અહીંયા હું તમને બતાવી રહ્યો છું કે 5 ડિસ્ચાર્જ તો યુ કેન સી રિવર રીચ રિવર સ્ટેશન પીએફ મીન્સ ફ્લો પ્રોફાઇલ નંબર 1 ફ્લો પ્રોફાઇલ નંબર 2 ફ્લો પ્રોફાઇલ નંબર 3 ફ્લો પ્રોફાઇલ નંબર 4 ફ્લો પ્રોફાઇલ નંબર 5 બરાબર આ એક એક્ઝામ્પલ માટે તમારી સ્ક્રીન પર મૂકેલું છે કે મારે જેટલા ડિસ્ચાર્જ માટે કામ કરવું એટલા ડિસ્ચાર્જ માટે હું અહીંયા એડ કરી શકું અહીંયા હું 6 લખીશ તો અહીંયા નવી એક છઠ્ઠી કોલમ એડ થઈ જશે રાઈટ નાઉ નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ ધ રીચ બાઉન્ડ્રી કન્ડિશન 1 મિનિટ કન્ડિશન નાઉ વોટ ઇઝ ધ યુઝ ઓફ રીચ બાઉન્ડ્રી કન્ડિશન હવે અગર તમે સ્ટેડી ફ્લો એનાલિસિસ કરશો તો એના અંદર તમારે ખાલી એક જ કન્ડિશન આપવાની ડાઉનસ્ટ્રીમ બીકોઝ અપસ્ટ્રીમ તો પાણી તમારું ફ્લો થાય છે રાઈટ બટ ઇફ યુ ગો ફોર અ અનસ્ટેડી ફ્લો એનાલિસિસ ધેન યુ નીડ ટુ ગો ફોર અ ટુ બાઉન્ડ્રી કન્ડિશન ઓન ધી અપસ્ટ્રીમ ફ્લો હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ એન્ડ ઓન ધ ડાઉનસ્ટ્રીમ નોર્મલ ડેમ બરાબર કારણ કે ફ્લો હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ એટલે કારણ કે એમાં ડેલી ડિસ્ચાર્જ બરાબર એટલે તમારો જે આપણો હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ ડ્રો થાય ને આ રીતે આપણો હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ ડ્રો થતો હશે કે આ જગ્યા પર આટલું ડિસ્ચાર્જ આ જગ્યા આ ટાઈમ ટાઈમ વર્સિસ ડિસ્ચાર્જનો જે કર્વ હોય એ આપણે એની વેલ્યુ એમાં એઝ અ અપસ્ટ્રીમ એટલે તમે જોયું હશે કે બાઉન્ડ્રી કન્ડિશન કઈ કઈ આપી શકીએ નોન વોટર સરફેસ એલિવેશન ક્રિટિકલ ડેપ્થ નોર્મલ ડેપ્થ રેટિંગ કર્વ એન્ડ ડિલીટ વોટ ડુ યુ મીન બાય નોન વોટર સરફેસ એલિવેશન અગર તમને તમારા એરિયાનું લેવલ ખબર છે કે ભાઈ આ લેવલથી ઉપર જાય તો ફ્લડ આવી શકે સો દેટ ઇઝ અ નોન વોટર સરફેસ એલિવેશન ક્રિટિકલ ડેપ્થ અગર તમને તમારા રિવરની ક્રિટિકલ ડેપ્થ ખબર હોય કે આટલું મારું નોર્મલ છે એની ઉપર જાય તો મારું ક્રોસ સેક્શન ઓવરટોપ થાય કાં તો મારો એરિયા ફ્લડિંગ થઈ જાય તો ધેટ ઇઝ કોલ્ડ એઝ અ ક્રિટિકલ ડેપ્થ નોર્મલ ડેપ્થ મીન્સ ઇટ ઇઝ ટેલિંગ અસ ધી સ્લોપ તમારા બેડનો સ્લોપ બેડનો સ્લોપ મીન્સ ધીસ ઇઝ માય રિવર આ રિવરનો બેડ સ્લોપ એટલે કે પેલું ટ્રેપેઝોઇડલ શેપ હોય ને ટ્રેપેઝ લાઈક સો ધીસ બેડ સ્લોપ ધીસ ઇઝ અ સાઇડ સ્લોપ એવી રીતે આનો અહીંયા બેડ સ્લોપ આવશે right so that can be taken as a normal depth right and rating curve એટલે મેં તમને કીધું ફ્લો હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ જે મેં તમને કીધું કે રેટિંગ કર્વ શું આપશે ગ્રાફિકલ રિપ્રેઝન્ટેશન બિટવીન ધ ડિસ્ચાર્જ વર્સિસ ટાઈમ રાઈટ એન્ડ ધીસ વે યુ વિલ બી એબલ ટુ એન્ટર ધી બાઉન્ડ્રી કન્ડિશન સો દેર આર ફોર બાઉન્ડ્રી કન્ડિશન નોન વોટર સરફેસ એલિવેશન ક્રિટિકલ ડેપ્થ નોર્મલ ડેપ્થ એન્ડ રેટિંગ કર્વ ઇફ યુ આર ગોઈંગ ફોર અ સ્ટેડી ફ્લો દેન યુ મસ્ટ હેવ ટુ યુઝ ધ નોર્મલ ડેપ ઓન ડાઉનસ્ટ્રીમ ઇન અપસ્ટ્રીમ અપસ્ટ્રીમમાં કશું યુઝ નહીં કરો કારણ કે અપસ્ટ્રીમમાં તો તમારો પાણી ફ્લો થઈને આવે છે બટ ઇફ યુ ગો ફોર અ અનસ્ટેડી ફ્લો દેન યુ નીડ ટુ ગો ફોર અ ફ્લો હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ એન્ડ ધ નોર્મલ ડેપ કારણ કે ફ્લો હાઇડ્રોગ્રાફ એટલે કારણ કે તમારો ડેલી ડિસ્ચાર્જ તમે યુઝ કરો છો તે અહીંયા અહીંયા એ રીતે તમારું વેરી થતું જશે એટલે નાઉ સ્ટેડી ફ્લો એનાલિસિસ આફ્ટર ડુઇંગ ઓલ ધીસ થિંગ યુ નીડ ટુ સેવ યોર ફાઇલ ગો ટુ ધ ફાઇલ ઓપ્શન સેવ યોર ટાસ્ક and then go to the run function in run function there is one option that is steady flow analysis just click on that and click on compute once you click on compute this type of window will be appear on our screen and if this અહીંયા જો આવી રીતે બ્લુ કલર ના પતી જાય એટલે સમજવાનું કે તમારું એનાલિસિસ ખતમ થઈ ગયું અને અગર જો અહીંયા રેડ દેખાડે અહીંયા વચ્ચે અહીંયા કઈ રેડ બતાડે તો અહીંયા નીચે ઓટોમેટિક એરર આવી જશે કે ભાઈ આ જગ્યા ઉપર આ વસ્તુ બરાબર રીતે રન થઈ નથી right so this is the first part of analysis is completed now I will go for a next that is the how to check the cross section whether it is overtop or not to sabthi pehla hu run ma jais from that run I will select hydraulic design function then for hydraulic design function this type of window will be appear on the screen go to type in that type select this uniform flow right when you click on the uniform flow this window will appear on your screen હવે તમે જોયું આમાં તમે જે ડેટા એન્ટર કરેલા ઓટોમેટિક આવી ગયા મેનિંગ્સ ની વેલ્યુ જે નાખેલી ઓટોમેટિક આવી ગઈ હવે તમારે શું કરવાનું છે ધેટ ઇઝ ધ મેઈન રોલ યુ નીડ ટુ એન્ટર અ સ્લોપ યુ નીડ ટુ એન્ટર અ ડિસ્ચાર્જ કોમ્પ્યુટર વિલ કેલ્ક્યુલેટ વોટર સરફેસ એલિવેશન બરાબર હવે આ તમને દેખાય છે ગ્રીન કલર પાણી છે આ ઓલરેડી ત્યાં એક્ઝિસ્ટેડ છે when I enter the discharge the water level will rise ye hu tumne bataya is result na andar right this is the slope now this is the slope of a river discharge which discharge you going to consider now say I am taking the discharge of 1945 flood of Surat city 29018 when I enter this discharge When I click on the compute, it will show whether my section is sufficient or not. If no, at what particular section accordingly the retaining wall or the embankment may be constructed for minimizing the flood which is entering into the surrounding region. Okay, fine. Yes. So it will check the section whether the cross section is sufficient or not. First thing. Second thing is it will also check how much height of the wall to be raised. Say this is my existing, right? Now if they check this is the natural wall, right? Now what they say, if I want to increase the height of the wall up to this, then my area is safe. This much area is safe, right? So software will tell you that, I will show you in the result how the software will show ke kitni height tak mere ko meri jo wall ki height badhani wo main bada sakta hu, right? So this way software will give you the idea. Software will also tell you that this area is under flooding, this area is under sub, up to this height it is flooded. Everything will be, you will get the idea into this software. Now I will show you the result analysis. Now see, this is the area from where they have carried out the stone pitching. See, this is the stone pitching. Isse stone pitching kehte hai, jiske upar aapne dekha hoga net laga hai. This is also one of the structural measure to minimize the flood. Here you can see it is the wall, embankment wall they have constructed, right? Now this is the natural. Now if the water is overturned from this, I need to raise the height of the wall up to certain height. I need to raise the height of the wall up to a certain height so that the water will not going to overtop. Now you can see the result. See, I am taking the example of 2006 flood having the discharge of 25,788. Now take the example of this image. You can see on one side it is overtop and on the other side it is safe. You can see the original length is, wait, I will just yes, you can see original up to this point, red point, say it is 4.5 and it is raised up to 7.8. it means that 3 meter height to be constructed to minimize the flood in this particular region, in this particular area. But here on the other side it is safe. Similarly, you can see in the cross section number 13, it is up to mark. अगर थोड़ा पानी में ज्यादा बढ़ा दूंगा देन फ्लड विल हैपन. देखिए आप देख सकते हो इधर इट इज एग्जैक्टली ऑन द लेवल, राइट? एंड हियर इट इज सेफ, राइट? नाउ 2006 फ्लड इन सूरत सिटी, यू कैन सी दिस इज द डिस्चार्ज. कितना डिस्चार्ज था? 9.09 लाख क्यूसेक ऑफ वाटर इज रिलीज फ्रॉम द डैम एट अ वन पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट at one particular time duration on 8th August. You can see, and you can see how much amount of water is there. See here also, ye dekho bridge kitna najik dikhai de raha aapko. This is Swaminarayan temple which is located at the Adajan area. You can also observe from the Sardar bridge, you can see it is flooded, right? Okay, now these are some of the images. The due to the flood, the retaining wall is washed out. You can see embankment is washed out. This is also, you can see, and this is a newly constructed wall. These are the some of the analysis. Now I will show you one image, means one just yes. Now one SMC has took the project. Just this is my concluding part only. Strengthening of river embankment, how to increase the height of the wall. So this is the 70 crore project at a Singapore location. They have a stretch up to 4.25 kilometer, right? Now I will show you that what will be the situation if I release the water from 4 lakh to 9 lakh. Now you focus on this image only. If I release 4 lakh cusec water and just focus on this grayish color, this much amount of area is flooded. When I increase the discharge 5 lakh, you just see the area increased. The area increased which are under flooding. right? You just focus on the grayish color. If I release 6 like you said, now you can see area increases. 7 lakh, you can see. 8 lakh, you can see. And lastly, 2006 flood, 9.09 lakh cusec. 85% of the Surat city is under flooding. How much? 85%. So this is the flood scenario of the Surat city when 2006 flood occurred. You can see 85%. Aapko area, tame hame 4 lakh cusec do. You can, aap 4 lakh cusec wala image dekh lijiye. And you can see the 9 lakh cusec. You will get the idea, right? So what are the findings? So already we have discussed in my slides only that if the cross sections were over top, then existing embankment or the retaining wall need to be raised. And if there are storm drain outlet, then it should be properly provided and prevent the entry of the flood water. And it is also strongly recommend that whatever the sections from critical in the present study, they require some restoration, or you can need to change the alignment of the cross section. Then they are very sensitive to high floods. Then no new construction can be allowed. And it is also strongly recommend that the either side of the bank, no encroachment is made up to 300 meter. Right. So these are the various findings of my study, which I just discussed with you. Okay. These are the references which I have used, and these are the books which you can consider as a references. So thank you so much for listening me. And these are my details. If you want to contact for any kind of this flood forecasting or any other work related to the flood or related to the water resource engineering, this is my email address and the contact number. You are free, feel free to contact me. So once again, thank you to the organizers and for inviting me and for giving me the opportunity to share my ideas on a virtual platform. So thank you. Now, if you have any kind of questions, then we can discuss. And I'm very happy to share among the answers. So
thanks to you, Prasang, sir, for sharing such a...
Sorry. Your voice is not audible, Yazad. Yazad, your voice is not audible properly.
And areas to key issues. And what are the employment opportunities?
Hello.
What is the industry to which this sector is open? And you have also shared a beautiful case study and the magnitude. Ma'am, is it audible? Case study in which you have, I think, entered about 4,000 cross-sectional data and got a beautiful output of like what would be the scenario when 9 lakh cusec would be the case and what. What would be the scenario?
Yazad, your voice is not audible again. Maybe some network issues. Hello.
So I
will
Can you hear me?
Your voice is audible. Yes.
Appreciation for your work and your.
Yes, sir. Actually, maybe sir, there is some network issue. Sir, am I audible, right?
Yes. Your voice is audible.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, Darshan sir, for giving that much nice knowledgeable session to our participants. So behalf of our participants, our organizing committee, our civil department, and from our S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, UMRAC, we will convey our sincere thanks to you, sir. Thank you for sparing time for this event to make all the participants enlightened with the very good knowledge in the area of water resource engineering with your expertise, your experience, and the study you have done for this speech specially. So on behalf of all the participants, again, I am congratulating you, sir, and also thanking you. And we are seeking such type of support in future too from your end, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone, for listening me. Thank you all the participants for actively participation in this today's workshop. And thank you all the organizations, organizers, and best wishes for the tomorrow's event. And once again, congratulations to all the organizers of this particular event. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Now, dear participants,